we're in Orange County, the Outlaw Y, if you will, but North 5, North 405 split. It's a pretty good venture. Come out from Southern Orange County, really nothing to worry about. Both freeway would be a little slow approaching the 55. When I mentioned the South 405, you just have to allow for this to construct a zone. 22 down with 55 is just plain slow going. Northbound fares a whole lot better. And do want to give you a heads up, if you're just showing us and leaving downtown Los Angeles up to West LA on the Santa Monica Freeway, boy, really got slow. It is slow every morning, I know you know that, but there's a problem. I'm a little bit of a small fire there, so it just added to it. Washington Boulevard, always a good drive out to a smoker city, not too bad. And North 405 from LAX up towards Santa Monica Freeway, the usual, unfortunately, normal slow all the way up. The line's open. Yes, I am the sky.
Did you know your old ugly driveway with patio for the rest of the year? Ready? I'm Mary Dennis for some time. During our free demolition event, we'll demolish and throw away your old materials and give you an instant cash recycling kit. This could save you thousands, but you must throw now. That's 800-PAVE-004. That's 800-PAVE-004. 800-PAVE-004 or systemtotal.com.
All orders must be placed by March 31st. See website for free details. Contact us by 661-575.
Looking over. Speaking of looks, guys, luck has nothing to do with it. Now, your top reasons to visit Marina.
Brian McKnight, live April 23rd.
Number two.
St. Patrick's Day freebie. Get a free Shamrock keychain March 17th.
And the number one reason.
The marketplace is coming. 7 different restaurants in one beautiful space for one special price. Coming soon.
Marengo, good times.
When Bill and I needed new windows over 20 years ago, we picked a company we thought would do a good job. We were so disappointed.
So we saw a genuine need for a company with strong character, one that people could have faith in.
American Vision Windows was born right then and there.
The best thing about working for American Vision Windows and with customers specifically is having their dreams come true. And we try to accomplish the best job we can to make them happy.
It was a great experience. I couldn't ask for anything better.
I've been in the construction trade for 35 years. The level of quality of products that they use for their prep work was top notch.
American Vision Windows continues to revolutionize the home improvement industry, one customer at a time, while changing the lives of our employees for the better. It's so simple.
Happy employees, happy customers.
0% interest, zero payments until 2023. Call 888-226-9908. That's 888-226-9908. Or visit AmericanVisionWindows.com.
Unapproved credit, not all applicants will qualify. Cannot be combined with any other offers. New customers only. Restrictions apply. Call or see website for details. Offer expires 3/31/2022. CSL number 7732.
Owen Pedersen and Owen have recovered over $10 billion for accident victims. Injury cases require layers of expertise and experience who can get results. I'm Susan Owen, managing partner at Owen Pedersen and Owen. We are a firm that knows what we're doing. Carefully consider the reputation and winning track record before you choose who to trust. You've been injured. Call Owen Pedersen and Owen, 888-OPO-WIN. And we do. 888-OPO-WINS or go to opolaw.com.
Want to boost your immunity and protect your community? Get a COVID-19 booster. They help keep you and others safe from the virus and its variants this season and beyond. If it's been at least 6 months since your last dose of Pfizer or Moderna, or at least 2 months since your last dose of J&J, it's time for a booster. Visit myturn.ca.gov to find a booster near you. Let's keep our immunity strong. Brought to you by the California Department of Public Health.
This is Jacob Amrani. If you've been in an accident, call 844-24-JACOB.
KFI AM 640.
More stimulating talk.
KFI AM 640. Bill Handel here. It is a Tuesday morning, March 8th, and just a whole hell of a lot is coming up. The invasion of Ukraine continues. Russia moving more and more of its troops and encircling cities, and it's a god-awful mess, and targeting civilians. I want to point that out. UN says already 2 million Ukrainians have fled, and it's going to be up to 10 million if this thing doesn't go away very quickly. That's the analysis. We're also waiting for President Biden to speak. Scheduled at 7:45. So whenever we're in the middle of whatever we're doing, when the president starts speaking, we'll go ahead and interrupt, because he's going to be talking about sanctions, And I'm going to explain why what he's going to say today, sanction-wise, doesn't mean a whole lot to Putin. But it's pretty important as to what he's going to say. So now let's move over to housing and why housing is so high here in California. And you know, well, a bunch of reasons, but I want to get specific about this. First of all, ready for this? 9 out of 10 Californians consider housing affordability a problem. 90% in this state. 1 in 3 said they're considering leaving California because of it. Although, you know, with saying you're going to and actually doing it are two different things. And so the state keeps on putting out more money, taking Fed money, and doing everything it can, not only for the homeless, but for affordable housing. Two different topics. So how hard is it to buy a home in California? Oh, it's hard. It is really hard. They make it very difficult. And mainly because of income. You can't afford one. In the late 1960s, the average California home cost 3 times the average household income. That was also the rent, the formula for rent. You don't want to go beyond 3 times what you make, or a third of what you make. And so if, let's say, you make $15,000 a year, or like $50,000 a year, a third of that is $15,000, give or take. So you're paying, what, $1,300 a month in rent, assuming that you're making $50,000. Well, guess what? Not even close. Not here in California. Look at the price of homes in California. The median home here is priced 2.5 times the median national home prices. Man, and this has gone way back. I mean, it literally started in the 70s and 80s when housing started to fall behind what was needed. The supply was less than we had out there. And what happened with COVID, that really nailed people. And as you would think, the wealthy people under any circumstances do better. So you had wealthy households with money to spend, capitalizing on low interest rates. So what happened? They bought, prices went up even more. And so we now have a median home price here in California, $827,000. If you're putting down 20% on a conventional loan, all you need is $160,000 in cash. After tax dollars, here you go. I want to buy a median price home here in California. And the other issue, who owns their own home? White people. White people are twice as likely to own their own home than black people, can you imagine? And rents are going through the roof. Interestingly, very high rent areas actually dropped. It's the median price and low rent areas that have gone through the roof. And the bottom line is wages just here in California don't keep up with rental costs. Even with, we've gotten some nice raises, people are earning more money. Employees, for the first time in decades, are actually holding the cards. But it hasn't even come close to keeping up with housing prices and rental prices. And even though we know that the Bay Area and the greater LA area are the worst areas for renters, this goes all over the state. I used to make fun of Bakersfield and Fresno, and you can get an apartment for $3 a month. It's gotten very expensive there too. And when you add homelessness to the housing shortage and what we do with it, it becomes almost an insurmountable problem, and they're dealing with it. And a couple things have some real political consequences. For example, how do you deal with housing? Well, you have a single family home, and next door, a developer is able to buy the lot next door, tear down the house, which has not been very well maintained, and put 4 units next to you. And homeowners are going, oh no, you're not going to do that to me. And there's a huge political onslaught against that, which means those bills in which that for the most part is happening are not happening. They're failing in the legislature. So, you know, yeah, we'll be talking about this a whole lot. But are there answers? There are, but they are very complicated. They are very expensive. They're going to take a long time to fix the problem, but you have to start someplace, don't you? I want to talk about maternity wards. Not only here in California, but all over the country. And here in California, we've got a huge problem. You know, the problem with nursing and staffing. Well, you take the obstetrics wards, and they're on a whole level, new level of real problems where patients, well, they're not even patients. And I'll explain, and then we're going to interrupt when the president starts speaking. Jennifer, what's going on in the 24-hour newsroom?
Well, more than 2 million refugees are now out of Ukraine. The United Nations just updated the numbers on the 13th day of fighting, but says the number could climb even higher today. A prisoner from Guantanamo Bay who tried to participate in the 9/11 attacks is being allowed to return to Saudi Arabia because a review board says he's no longer a significant threat to national security. And today is the 111th International Women's Day. Today's theme is Break the Bias, which encourages people to call out gender bias, discrimination, and stereotyping in the continued push for women's equality. From the HMS Capital Weather Center, sunny today, highs will be in the mid-60s at the beaches to the mid-70s inland. This report is brought to you by HMS Capital. From the Southern California Toyota Dealers Traffic Center, let's go places like off to the 710.
Boy, boy, getting busy, that's for sure. But if you're leaving Long Beach now around the Queen Mary, coming up from the docks, the slowest section is traditionally getting to that the 91 and the 105 especially. And then from that point up to the I-5 is going to be slow. Southbound still in fairly good shape to the 91. After that, though, pretty good shape to the harbor. Now, coming by in a few seconds here, if I could. We came through the north 405, 605 up to 710, but then we turned around. There's supposed to be a problem at Lakewood. We're over it now. If you're coming up from the 22, it's good. I don't see anything. I think whatever it was is cleared very quickly. It's getting to slow up towards the 710, but kind of boring drive stuff up to the South Bay. Not too bad yet. Jeff Bond, KFI in the sky.
Have you looked at the value of your home lately? I looked yesterday. I kind of yelped with joy, quite honestly. And so some people are thinking about selling a house, right? But then when you think about selling a house, the hurdles and the hassles, the showings, the listings, you don't want to go through all that. I have a way you don't have to. Sell your home the new-fashioned way with opendoor.com. It's a whole new way to sell your home with Open Door, and you don't have to make the repairs yourself or do any prep. All you have to do is go to opendoor.com, answer some really simple questions about your house, just the basics, bedrooms, bathrooms, square footage, that kind of thing. Then, Opendoor takes that information, and within just a few minutes, it compares your home to others in the neighborhood. I went through the process within minutes. I had a real competitive offer for my house. So sell your home the new-fashioned way at opendoor.com/KFI. Offer eligibility varies. Opendoor is represented by Opendoor Brokerage, Inc., license number 02061130 in California, and Opendoor Brokerage, LLC in its other market. Sell your home the new-fashioned way at opendoor.com/KFI.
KFI AM 640.
An iHeart radio station.
More stimulating talk.
I'm 640. Bill Handel here on a Tuesday morning, March 8th. We are awaiting the president, who is going to speak, and we know he's going to be talking about sanctions against Russia, and then right afterwards I'm going to dive into what he is saying and what it actually means, what he is doing, what he's announcing today. But what I'm going to do is start on another topic. And this is something where I get in a lot of trouble for. And it has to do with the fact that I'm not an exceptionalist. I always argue with people that say America is the best country in the world. Well, in many ways, it is the best country in the world. It's my adopted country, and I would live no place else. However, what does that mean, the best country in the world? Our literacy rate is in the 20s. Turkestan, Georgia, near Russia, has a higher literacy rate. Russia has a higher literacy rate. We have more illiterate people than these tiny little Balkan countries. So if you ask about literacy, are we the greatest country in the world? We are not. How about infant mortality? Not even close. I'm going to get into that in a moment. How about higher education? Oh, we're the best in the world. How about medical care? We're the best in the world for some people. For relatively some people. Go ask someone in Tennessee, living in a rural area, and talk about how this is the best medical care in the world. And therein lies the story that I want to share with you about maternity wards that has been lost in this talk about the pandemic. We know nurses, you know, shortage of doctors, and just how few medical personnel are available relative to the number that are needed during COVID and even now. And this also has to do with maternity wards. And therein is a huge problem. And now we're back to, we're the best country in the world. We don't even have close enough maternity wards, and they're shutting down. Where? In Los Angeles, we have plenty. San Francisco, we have plenty. The big cities, we have plenty. You can't argue about that. But if you go to the rural areas, not even close. And it's making it very difficult. And this adds to the mortality rate. If there are no hospitals nearby that have OB departments, if someone is 30 minutes away from a hospital that can deliver a baby, what ends up happening? They do it at the side of the road. Now, we talk about, and it's a great story, cop comes there and delivers the baby right there at the side of the road, and it's a great human interest story. And it is. I mean, the heroics, etc. But what is not mentioned is how dangerous that was, and the chances of infant mortality or serious injury to the child or the mother happening during a roadside delivery. I mean, that becomes astronomical. And it's all because if it were a 3-minute drive to the hospital, there'd be no problem. If it were a 10-minute drive. But in some cases, it's a half-hour drive. It can be an hour drive because that area simply doesn't have a maternity ward. And they're closing down like crazy, particularly, how unusual, communities of Black and Hispanic Americans, already less likely to have easy access to health care. Before the recent closures, more than half of the rural counties in the U.S. didn't have a nearby hospital where babies could be delivered. I mean, there are clinics, but when you talk about delivering babies, the pandemic is a huge reason. I mean, you know that. Hospitals are filled with long term shortage of doctors and nurses and healthcare workers. And if you don't have them, you have to shut down the clinic. I mean, you have no choice. And since we have declining birth rates in this country, the need for additional or more maternity wards or you don't need as many, except in rural areas. It's not a question of not needing as many, it's a question of where they are. And they're shutting down where they're needed the most. Because there may be one in a given area. I mean, here, let's say someone has to deliver a baby. How many hospitals within 15 minutes of this studio can deliver a baby? Half a dozen? Maybe a dozen? Now, you go out to a real rural area, and, for example, I was driving from Las Vegas to visit my friend, and I'm driving down from Las Vegas, and I go through that entire rural area, go down the 5, and you're going through Baker and Fresno, et cetera, and I'm thinking there are 45-minute stretches where it's just empty roads. And there are people that live in those areas. You wonder, you see those clumps of trailers where people live. You go, where do they even get water? I mean, who the hell lives with 30 different trailers? That's your community. But where's the nearest medical clinic? Half an hour away? Does it have an obstetric ward? It does not. It's usually a little clinic, and it's manned by a medical student. Well, maybe a doctor, nurse. But the point is,
that it is a, there's a real dearth of this stuff. And we've got a real problem on our hands. Sometimes these hospitals close down temporarily, and then find out it just doesn't make sense to even keep open. Pandemic money that kept a lot of these places alive has been running out. Also, you have a general trend of consolidation and specialization. There aren't enough people out there. Doctors want to deliver babies. There's not enough money there. Also, a doctor is instantly sued. Oh, that's another one. America is the greatest country in the world. Yeah? Ask doctors who get sued every day. Obstetrics? The anomaly rate at these kids that are born with a pretty severe problem is 2-3%. And that's just the way nature works. That's without any malpractice. That's without anybody doing anything wrong. 2-3% is nature's way of producing babies, and you have the anomaly rate, okay? If a doctor does 100 deliveries per year, and obstetricians do usually a lot more who are obstetricians, and you've got a 2-3% anomaly rate, I guarantee you there will be 2-3% lawsuits against the doctor for malpractice because the child was born with some serious issue. You cannot, we in America do not accept that nature, that God simply produces kids that are screwed up physically and mentally, but we don't know that till later on, with a small percentage. That doesn't happen. So if you go to areas where, for example, of course, doctors have to have medical malpractice insurance, $130,000 a year for obstetricians, making it impossible to even have obstetricians. No one goes into OB anymore. The risk is too high. Their own hospitals out there. Their money isn't enough to be made. It's just very difficult. I mean, our system is such that if you had planned to say, let's figure out a way to close down obstetric wards in places where it's needed the most, you're going to find rural areas. You're going to find areas that minorities live in. And there are stories after stories that we're hearing about this. I mean, we are in a mess when it comes to medical care in this country. And it's not getting any better. We have a Medicare system, which incidentally is socialized medicine. For those of you that are screaming socialized medicine, that's what it is. You hit 65, you're now in the magic area of socialized medicine. Big pharma, look, we're the best country in the world. Especially when it comes to drugs. How many people can't afford drugs? Now, again, and I want to point this out. I know I'm going to get into it. When I say I'm not exceptionalist, I describe America, and it's more complicated than we're just the best country in this world. And one of my huge problems is Medicare, is medical care. We just are rotten. Our health, our mortality rate, our longevity rate doesn't compare to other first world countries. And top among the issues are the fact that OB wards are being shut down. And you've got people that will be, what it does is cause the mortality rate, the problem from our kids being born, to go straight up, which puts us in an even worse position. All right, we are waiting for the president to give his remarks on the sanctions that he is invoking. So what we're going to do is we're going to continue on with the show as it normally is, and then we'll interrupt what is happening. In the meantime, I guess we're going to start with Tech Tuesday, Alex. We are not. We are. We're going to start with a Tech Tuesday with Rich DeMuro, and if Rich gets interrupted, although I think Rich has more to say than the president does on this one.
Ouch.
You'll hear right after what he says. I'll get into it and go, come on, really? And I just can't wait for that.
Okay, well, I'm going to stay tuned because maybe he's going to prove you wrong.
Okay, I'm glad. I hope so.
I'm willing to bet no.
Handel versus the president when we come back.
KFI AM 640 live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
Nothing gets past us. We are on it.
KFI.
KOST HD2.
Los Angeles, Orange County.
Live everywhere on the iHeartRadio app.
No more. I'm Jennifer Jones-Lee, live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom. President Biden's decided to ban Russian oil imports. The move follows pleas by Ukrainian President Zelensky to the U.S. and Western officials to stop buying oil from Russia. Energy exports have helped feed the Russian war machine with a steady flow of cash despite sanctions against Russia's financial sector, as Handel mentioned. Any moment now, we are expecting the president to announce more sanctions on Russia. As soon as he steps to the podium, we will bring him to you live. Now, the exodus of people fleeing Ukraine has reached 2 million in Poland. This volunteer sees how refugees of all ages have suffered.
Most of them are just very, very tired, terrified, and confused because they don't know what to expect. It's also hard for us to see heartbreaking children, so we're trying to give them sweets.
The Russian invasion has trapped people inside cities that are running low on food, water, and medicine. Russia says it has opened up humanitarian corridors to allow civilians to leave without being subject to bombing or shooting. LA is cutting 5 miles off and 177 miles around the city streets thanks to a new law.
Our streets couldn't keep up.
LA DOT General Manager Salita Reynolds says state law has required the city to increase speed limits, and the results were not an accident.
More and more people who are walking and biking and relying on transit to get from A to B every day were losing their lives.
Changes to that state law now allow cities more control.
Humans were not designed to survive an encounter with a moving vehicle going faster than 40 miles an hour.
The new speed limits signed into law by the mayor yesterday are expected to go into effect in about a month. In L.A., Corbin Carson, KFI News.
And a 26-year-old man from Stockton's been sentenced to 12 and a half years in prison for pimping an underage girl from L.A.
Federal prosecutors say 26-year-old Christian Augustus repeatedly used violence to maintain the control of the girl while financially benefiting from the money she earned. Augustus, who's also known as Sir Seiko, pleaded guilty in July of 2021 to one count of interstate transportation of a minor to engage in prostitution and criminal sexual activity. Augustus forced the girl to work on the streets and advertised her services online, and took the girl from Southern California and made her work in L.A., Las Vegas, and Phoenix. Steve Gregory, KFI News.
Jeff will text your drive on the 91 in just a moment.
If you own a business and manage to keep five or more people on the payroll during the pandemic, there is a government program, it's new, that will pay you tens of thousands of dollars per employee. And this is not a loan, this is a grant. A lot of red tape, though. It's complicated federal bureaucracy. So let me suggest contacting InnovationRefunds.com. They cut through that red tape, get you the money. They're experts at this. And they do all the legwork and do not charge any money until you actually receive the money. And then they share a percentage of the money they get for you. So you don't pay up a dime. That's InnovationRefunds.com. Now, in another business, they got my business a six-figure refund. Here, the average client gets $250,000. Go to InnovationRefunds.com, click on the Qualify Me button, answer a few questions, then they take over. InnovationRefunds.com, no risk, high reward, InnovationRefunds.com.
Taking a look at your KFI financial report, the Dow is up 10, S&P down 2, NASDAQ up 8. And the average price of a gallon of unleaded gas in California today is $5.44. Your SoCal weather from KFI, it's a sunny day ahead. Temperatures will be in the 60s and 70s, little bit of a breeze out there, and then tomorrow, partly cloudy and cooler. Right now, it is 47 right here in Burbank. From the Southern California Toyota Dealers Traffic Center, let's go places like the 91.
Boy, get jumpy. It must be a big party in Gardena. There's a lot of volume down the Westbound 91. Starts around Carmenita before the 605 and lasts all the way over. He said once you get past Long Beach Boulevard, things will improve a little bit. The Westbound 105, about the same thing going into LAX. All lanes are open, but just a slow drive, that's for sure. Now, as I speak, you were over the Golden State Freeway, passing over the Glendale Freeway. North 5 around the 110, there was something reported. Looks like a false alarm to me. There was nothing down there, but it is definitely slow. And I think once you get up to about Los Feliz, things will improve going up to Burbank. Southbound morning drive slow now all the way down to the very busy East LA Interchange. Jeff Barr, KFI in the sky.
KFI.
live.
More stimulating talk.
An iHeart radio station.
All the latest on gadgets and stuff with KFI's resident handsome nerd.
It's Tuesday with Rich DeMiro.
And good morning. Bill Handel here. Tuesday morning, March 8th, as we await the president. He is going to be giving his remarks on sanctions against Russia. And these are new sanctions he's going to announce today. And as soon as he starts speaking, we're going to cut to the president and carry it live. In the meantime, Tech Tuesday with Rich DeMuro. We do this every Tuesday. His Instagram is at Rich on Tech. Good morning, Rich.
Good morning to you, Bill.
All right, you know, you're probably going to be interrupted by our president.
That's okay.
And what you have to say is, I think, a whole lot more interesting. But that's my...
Is it, though? I don't know.
No, I think so. I think so. I think people really like this segment. So let's go into a couple of... a couple of topics here, and I love this one, and that is you get to host your own call-in radio show. You too can work on radio. That's like you can learn how to drive the big rigs.
Right.
Yes.
This is pretty wild. So this is like a direct affront to you, Bill. This is Amazon coming after you. They have a new app called Amp. And maybe not so much you, because you're not playing music, but this is really a new way that people can host their own radio shows. And yeah, we've heard, you know, you've probably heard of Twitter Spaces, you heard of Clubhouse back in the day. Audio is really hot. I mean, go figure. You've been doing it for how many years, and suddenly the tech companies figure out that audio is hot. But this app, what makes it unique is that Amazon is letting creators blend in music, so real music. So they've licensed songs from Universal, Sony, and Warner, as well as some independent music companies. So you can literally go on this app, fire it up, and say, hey, this is Rich DeMuro, and here's a new song from Taylor Swift. And then, you know, you can talk in the middle of it and then play another song. But the reality is, who's listening? Because I went on this app this morning, and it's not like it's on the radio. So that's the problem, is getting the listeners there.
Yeah, well, that's like anything when you're dealing with the internet and terrestrial radio, which is what we do, and the podcasting. I remember podcasting, when it started, it was literally a joke. I mean, we just all laughed. Naturally, it has become so popular and so ubiquitous that... now there's a lot of talk about terrestrial radio disappearing, and it's all going to be via the internet. But the point is, how many radio stations are there in L.A.? I know, but maybe 70, 80 radio stations. How many people work, for example, at KFI or work at your station, KTLA? And I'm talking about on the air. A handful here, a handful there. How many podcasts are there out there? It's in the, what, hundreds of thousands, if not the millions. How does anybody break through?
Well, that's the thing. I mean, you either bring an audience, or you either have a built-in audience. The celebrities, of course, have done really well with podcasts because they already have a built-in audience. But there are people that have been able to build audiences. But it's one of these things. It's just like YouTube. It's just like Twitter. Yes, there are always breakout people, and there will always be breakout stars, but then there's tens of thousands more that will never break out, never make a dime, never do anything. Now, I'm not saying you shouldn't do anything. You shouldn't act because of that. I mean, it's like this town was built on people that come here with dreams, and 99.9% of them never realize those dreams when it comes to acting or modeling or whatever. But you still have to do it if you feel like it's something you want to do. And so I think with Amazon putting out this app, it enables people to do something that they think they can do really well. And you never know. I mean, someone will break out of this. I mean, I actually think they said, was it Nicki Minaj? Someone's actually hosting a show. Yeah, Nicki Minaj is going to bring a radio show to this app called Queen Radio. So clearly they're you know, banking on her to bring some people to this app, make them download the app, and then maybe they find other shows that they like as well. But chances are they'll probably just stick to her show, honestly.
So does Amazon have plans to market this out in the open marketplace? I mean, I think bottom line, if Amazon aggressively starts marketing this platform, you got a shot.
Well, yeah, I think so. But here's the thing with all these tech companies that we've seen. You know, they're very all over the place. So Amazon's really into this right now. I mean, Bill, did we talk about the fact that Amazon is closing those physical stores that they opened? You know, the four-star and the bookstores. I mean, these are like big physical stores that they opened up at the malls across America. You know, 68 stores here in the U.S. and the U.K., and they're shutting those stores down with all the people there and all that, you know, all the, they had to set them up. This is an app. It takes about 5 minutes to shut it down if they feel like it's not really taking off. And we've seen that happen with Google. We've seen it with Apple. You know, these tech companies, they shift gears based on what's making them money and what's important to them. They have this guy behind the app that, you know, they kind of, I don't know if he's a radio guy, previous radio guy, but, you know, they've got him talking about how radio is so important and how, you know, different cities had different flavors for their radio stations, and he wants to bring that idea back to this thing. So we'll see. We'll see what happens with it.
All right, let's move over. Apple. I just got my Apple phone replaced because the one I bought, remember we were talking about getting an Apple phone? I finally did it, and it turned out to be a dud. I actually have to have it replaced.
The new one?
Yeah, brand new one, and it was a lemon. Steve Jobs has to be rolling over in his grave producing a dud of an Apple phone. I mean,
that's still rare, but it does happen. I mean, it's a device, I guess.
Yeah, you're looking at who it happened to. So in any case, and this is what Apple does. They're having an event today at 10 a.m. Do we know what they're introducing? Do we know what it's about? Do they give you hints?
Well, they usually give you a hint in the invitation. So this year's invitation, or this month's invitation, was called Peak Performance, P-E-E-K. Now, the things that, you know, the rumors are saying they're going to introduce is a cheaper iPhone, like this, it's called the iPhone SE. They're on their third, this would be the third generation of it. It would be the first one with 5G. Boring. I mean, not that exciting. A new iPad Air, boring, not that exciting. The thing that people come to these Apple events for is a look at what's going to happen next. And so far, Apple, we've heard all this stuff about Apple coming out with an electric car. We've heard all this stuff about Apple coming out with a virtual reality headset. Two of the biggest places where we're seeing a lot of movement in the tech industry, and Apple is just sitting back and waiting for others to do this, and we don't know why. We need a little hint from Apple, and that's why Peak Performance, people think, maybe that's a car, peak at their performance, or peak, you know, maybe that refers to the eyes for this virtual reality headset. But if we don't get something like that, this event's going to be kind of a yawner.
How do you keep, let's say they announce an electric car, how do you keep anything like that under wraps, other than the announcement itself, we're going to go forward with an electric car? I mean, I'm assuming there is no research being done, there's certainly no prototypes being built. Can you keep that secret?
I mean, it's getting tougher and tougher to keep that secret, which is why I don't think there's going to be that announcement today. Because Apple, you know, we've heard little inklings of how they've hired people from Tesla and hired people from Ford, and then the people from Tesla and Ford left, and it's been kind of a rotating door with Apple's car project, and we've been hearing about their car project now for minimum 5 years. I think it was called Project Titan at some point, but we haven't heard much, and we haven't seen any renderings. We haven't seen any, like you said, these prototype vehicles. You know, I just went to a Polestar. I don't know if you've heard of Polestar. They're an electric car company partly owned by Volvo, and they brought me to this rooftop in Beverly Hills, really fancy place, to show me, you know, this prototype of a fancy, more than $100,000 sports car that they're introducing that's all electric. And they're showing it to me, this was last week. This car's not going to come out for another year or two, but they have the prototype. They had to crane it into the top of this building because it was on the rooftop. So the reality is, you know, we see things from these car companies many, many months or maybe years before they even make it to market. So for Apple to do anything right now, they would, you know, there's no way they have a car ready to go that people can buy tomorrow. This would be another couple years, but it would maybe be a shadow of the car. You know, maybe they'd show us the front end of the car or something like that. But they've got to give us something to go on, you know, something that people can really feast into with Apple to get excited again.
Yeah, I was in a mall and was looking at, I think it was Lucid, a car.
Yeah.
Just out, a beautiful car.
And there was the prototype there in the showroom. And I said, can I see the engine? Oh, we don't have the engine in it. It's literally the shell of the car. Would you like to spend $100,000? You can sign up right now and put a deposit. We're going to come back and still do plenty of Tech Tuesday with Rich DeMuro before the president starts speaking. In the meantime, let's check in with Jennifer live from the KFI 24-hour newsroom.
Evacuations of people fleeing Ukrainian cities along safe corridors have started. Meanwhile, officials say the exodus of refugees from Russia's invasion of the country has reached 2 million. Jury selection starts today in the trial of four men accused of conspiring to kidnap Michigan Governor Gretchen Whitmer. The government says the men were upset about Whitmer's stay-home policy and other COVID restrictions in the state. And President Biden is headed to Texas later today. He'll be in Fort Worth to speak about veterans issues, specifically the effects of toxic burn pits common in war zones. Your SoCal weather from KFI comes from the HMS Capital Weather Center. Sunny today, highs will be in the mid-60s at the beaches to the mid-70s inland. This report is brought to you by Rocket Mortgage. From the Southern California Toyota Dealers Traffic Center, let's go places. We're heading over to the 134 and the 101.
You bet you just flew over your roof, Jennifer. The drive, if you're leaving Pasadena, perhaps. If you left on time this morning, pretty much no matter where you are right now, but if you left on time, it's just one of those mornings. It's the usual slow drive, so I hope you're prepared for that. So back to 134, not bad at all. Getting a little slower around Cahuenga as you go through the interchange. Then the 101 takes over. We're over Reseda Boulevard right now. It's just a slow morning drive. Same thing for the eastbound drive, by the way, approaching the 405. Reseda is about, Tampa is about where all that starts. South 405 has really been something else all morning. It's one of those drives, pretty much Sherman Way through the 101, up the hill, and maybe downhill. You have to wait to Wilshire before things get better. You're going down to LAX, things are pretty good. Look at the 210 coming up, don't go away. Jeff Barr, KFI in the sky.
When you buy a home with Rocket Mortgage, you'll have a team of experts to help you every step of the way. Forget unwanted surprises and unanswered questions. That's not how they work. You'll feel informed and confident at every turn. When you're ready to buy or refinance, Rocket can.
This report is sponsored by Cal Recycle. Want to make sure your recycling actually gets recycled? Californians are recycling smarter with tips on how to empty, dry, and sort properly. Visit irecyclesmart.com to take your recycling to the next level. That's irecyclesmart.com. Do your part. Recycle smart.
The holy grail of home ownership is to pay off that mortgage as soon as possible. Well, I want to explain a totally different way of thinking about your home, your money. Paying off your home makes no sense. In the past few years, your home's value has increased like crazy. Home prices have gone up exponentially, and that means your home's equity has grown exponentially too. And all that value in your house is just sitting there doing absolutely nothing. Money is so cheap right now, and you probably think that the money in your home is safe and investing that money is dangerous. Not necessarily true. If your home loan rate is 3% or under, you only have to make more than 3%. The problem is that paying off your home is so deeply rooted, you probably learned it from your parents. Their goal is to pay off the house, live modestly into old age, minimal expenses. Today, it is totally different. We don't have guaranteed pensions to count on anymore. Social Security benefits don't let you keep your lifestyle. So your retirement is probably powered by your investment. I was talking to Mark Price at HMS Capital about this, and I asked him, how about a 30-year loan versus a 15-year loan? He said he'd recommend a 100-year loan because he believes the goal is not to pay off your house, but put your home's money to work for you. If this way of thinking about your home, your money, your future makes sense, call HMS Capital at 833-255-5698, 833-255-5698. HMS Capital encourages you to apply with them and another lender at the same time. They're that confident they can get you the best deal. HMS Capital is the only lender I know that does that. I've done two mortgages with HMS Capital. I've known Mark for over 16 years. So call HMS Capital at 833-255-5698 or visit hmscapital.com. That's hmscapital.com.
HMS Capital Funding is a DBA of Golden Campfire, Inc. MNLS ID number 2427. HMS Capital is licensed by the Department of Financial Protection and Innovation. Under the California Residential Mortgage Lending Act. License number 4130360. Equal housing lender.
Do you need new blinds or shades? Blindster.com offers custom-made blinds, shades, and shutters shipped directly to you at prices less than big-box retailers. Blindster blinds are easy to install and guaranteed to fit. Don't overpay for new blinds. Shop Blindster today and save big. Blindster.com.
The kitchen is the centerpiece of your home, centerpiece of my home. There's no component that's going to play a bigger role in the look and function of your kitchen than the cabinets. And if they're showing age, call Reborn Cabinets. They'll provide a custom solution that perfectly suits your needs.
Yes, sir.
Through March 31st, you can save $1,000 on your kitchen refacing project, plus get up to 10 free drawers valued at $2,000. Or just call Reborn Cabinets, 888-2-REBORN. Or go to ReBornCabinets.com and turn your ordinary kitchen into extraordinary. California State License Number 443682.
I'm attorney Darren Cavanoki from 1-800-NO-CUFFS. Can you do the alphabet backwards? ZYXWV. Yeah, try doing that by the side of the road. So if you get pulled over, don't wing it. Call us at 1-800-NO-CUFFS.
Net blockade was really effective. You can go. All the regulations, though? I mean, what does effective mean?
I screwed up life for 3 weeks.
Yeah, well, you're normally somebody that hates it when the protesters block, like, the west side streets there.
Yeah, it depends whether I agree with the protest or not.
Exactly.
John and Ken.
If I think you're full of... get out of my way.
Weekdays at 2 on KFI. Yeah,
okay.
AM 640, Bill Handel on a Tuesday morning, March 8th. We continue on with Tech Tuesday. Rich DeMuro.